Have you ever wondered why there's been such an increase in superhero pop culture in recent years? Specifically, the rise in superhero movies? No? Oh. Well, this video is kind of pointless then, huh? What? You do? Oh, perfect. Start the music back up. Well, let's take a journey and go in depth into why superheroes have become so popular. Some people think the superhero genre has been overused. Many turn to superhero movies to escape the reality of a stressful world, to see a character like themselves on the big screen, or to marvel at the production value and technological innovation of these films.
See what I did there? Marvel at the production? Sorry.
A common reason that people have turned to superheroes is when there has been some sort of local or global crisis. And that is exactly where we're going to start. An early example of the comic book scene blowing up is because of the two world wars. A quote from an article by the Daily Q states, "Superhero comic books became really popular in the late 1930s and early 1940s, between the two world wars. They also increased in popularity in the 1960s during the Cold War, when people needed an embodiment of reassurance. This is one of the reasons that Captain America got so popular, because he, just like many other citizens at the time, was a World War II soldier. People could feel for him and relate to this new character that they were seeing on the shelves." The wars were just one example of the crises that made people want to escape to an easier, simpler world. A more recent example of people turning to superheroes in a crisis was in 2008. Credit to the New York Film Academy for this one. "The most significant and grim factor behind the rise of superhero movies has been the economic crash of 2008. People suddenly wanted escapism into a different world where the hero always triumphed and where the distinction between good and bad were easy to tell." During this year came the start of a now titan of superhero movies, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, or MCU for short, with its debut film, Iron Man. Superhero movies during this time always had some sort of happy ending, a contrast to what most people saw in their daily lives. That is why they became so appealing, which brings us into our next topic. When it comes to a wider audience connecting to the characters that they see in superhero media, audiences can refer to some of these movies and comic books made in recent years, like the Ultimate Spider-Man series and the Ms. Marvel series. These two comic stories are part of a new wave of superheroes, introducing Miles Morales and Kamala Khan. Miles being the first Afro-Latino comic character, and Kamala being the first Pakistani-American Muslim character to have their own Marvel titles. Another example of diversity and connections to the media is recent examples made by Marvel and DC. Titles such as Marvel's Black Panther in 2018, DC's Wonder Woman in 2017, and Marvel's Captain Marvel in 2019. Black Panther was the first predominantly black cast and crew in the franchise, and Wonder Woman and Captain Marvel being the first female-led superhero movies of this generation. Not only are these movies a step forward in the representation of diverse identities, but they also proved to be box office and critical successes, with Captain Marvel gaining $1.12 billion in the box office worldwide, and Black Panther gaining $1.344 billion, as well as being the first comic book slash superhero film to win an Academy Award, and the first MCU movie to even get nominated for an Academy Award. Another insanely big factor to why these movies have gained so much in the box office is because of the pure visual talent on the screen. The artists behind these works can create visual spectacles with the technological advancements of computer-generated imagery, or CGI. Going back to that article by the Daily Q, "With cutting-edge technology, computer-generated imagery, and special effects, the superhero genre invites audiences to the adventures of larger-than-life characters with extraordinary power." A fantastic example of these advancements in CGI is the 2018 film by Sony Animation's Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Here's a quote from a West Side Story article. "The utmost selling point for Spider-Verse is the groundbreaking animation. To describe the animation style, think of a prototypical three-dimensional animated palette combined with a hand-drawn slate on the surface, all the while having a glitchy graffiti effect on top and a bucket of color splashed all over it." If you'd like to see a more in-depth look of how exactly these breathtaking effects were made, I recommend this video from Wired, titled "How Avengers Endgame's Visual Effects Were Made," or a few videos from a channel I personally have been watching for years, Corridor Crew's Different VFX Artist Reacts to Marvel. There's been about three, so you can watch whichever you'd like. In conclusion, sure, some people think that this genre has been overused, but hopefully this video has given light to why it has increased in popularity. By highlighting examples of how viewers turn to these movies during times of stress to identify with a character on the screen who represents their life experiences, or to check out the latest in computer animation, it is easy to see why this genre has become increasingly popular. Thanks for watching.